the limit, first of all, you just substitute directly the limit value. See, limit expands to 0 sin x. And you directly replace x with 0, that is sin 0, and sin 0 is 0. So this is 0. Limit extends to 0 cos x. Limit extends to 0 cos x in the sense its value is cos 0 and cos 0 is 1. So the answer is 1. Whereas limit extends to 0 cos x by x. This time when you replace x with 0, you will get that cos 0 by 0, that is equals to 1 by 0, and the value is infinity. Okay, all these three things are clear. But whereas when you think about limit extends to 0 sin x by x, replace x with 0, sin 0 by 0, sin 0 is 0 divided by 0, this is an indeterminate form. And to avoid this, we need to use this sin x expansion. Okay, see, these expansions, we have a separate discussion related to the expansions. Okay, all these expansions are proposed by Taylor, a mathematician named Taylor. Okay, Taylor series and their expansions I will discuss you in another class. Okay, first of all, you just observe this sin x. Sin x is x minus x cube by 3 factorial like this. So sin x is equals to x into 1 minus x square by 3 factorial plus x power 4 by 5 factorial minus and so on. Just you just common out that x. Send that x this side. What will happen now? Sin x by x is equals to 1 minus x square by 3 factorial plus x power 4 by 5 factorial minus and so on. Just apply limit on both sides as x is tending to 0. So now this time limit extends to 0. Sin x by x is equals to, as x is tending to 0, we need to replace x with 0. Everything will get, everything is 0 except this one. So limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1. So with the help of this standard trigonometric limit, limit extends to 0, sin x by x is equals to 1, we will generate many other trigonometric limits and we will solve many other problems related to trigonometry. Okay? Right. So you just consider all these things in A. Based on this limit extends to 0 sin x by x as 1, now I will give you some more bits in B. Okay? Have a look. Right. B. Yeah, limit extends to 0 sin x by x is 1. And now what you say about limit extends to 0 sin kx by x. Limit extends to 0 sin kx by x. See, very simple. As x is tending to 0, k into x is also tending to 0. Since here it is sin kx, we need to make the denominator also kx. So multiply with k and divide with k. So then it becomes like this. Yeah. Limit extends to 0 sin kx divided by kx into k. Now just look at this limit extends to 0 sin kx by kx. As x is tending to 0, kx is also tending to 0. So limit kx tends to 0 sin kx by kx into k. This value is 1 and that is k. So 1 into k is equals to k. Okay. So always you need to observe this particular pattern. Sin x by x, as x is tending to 0 and its limit value is 1. So instead of that x, if we have kx, then the value is k. Okay. Now, first suppose the problem I ask you like this. Limit x tends to, yeah, you may say 2 sin x by x. What to say about its value? As x is tending to 0, its value is 1 using series expansion. But here x is tending to 2. This time, you just replace directly x with 2. What will happen? Sin 2 by 2. Sin 2 by 2 is a determinate form. So the value is sin 2 by 2 itself only. Okay? So usually people look this sin x by x pattern and they say the answer as 1. But you need to observe this x tending to 0 also. Here x is tending to 2, so don't use formula, just substitute directly, your answer is sin 2 by 2, okay, that's one thing. And another thing is, yeah, limit, extends to 0, sin ax divided by sin bx. Limit extends to 0, sin ax divided by sin bx. So what you say about it? Limit extends to 0, sin ax by sin bx, just divide with x, numerator and denominator, you will get your answer as a by b. That's it. Or in the same way, if you have a limit extends to 0, sin, suppose I will say sin 3x plus sin 7x divided by x. What will happen? You just split it. Sin 3x by x plus sin 7x by x. As x is tending to 0, sin kx by x is k. So sin 3x by x is 3 as well. Sin 7x by x is 7 and the value is 10. Okay, so these are some simple problems based on that limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1. Have a look and I will give you some more problems. Next thing, you may take it as C. Limit extends to 0, tan x by x. So again, if you replace x with 0, tan 0 by 0 is an indeterminate form because tan 0 is 0. So you will get 0 by 0 and indeterminate form. To avoid that indeterminate form, we have two options. One way is moving with series expansion. Other way is using any standard limit, other standard limit. And another way is geometrical approach. See, for limit extends to 0, sin x by x as 1. Limit extends to 0, tan x by x is also 1. That's what we are going to prove now. There is a geometrical discussion related to these two things. And I will discuss it in further classes. But at present, we are moving with series expansion. Already, we proved that limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1. Now, I am going to utilize that idea in this, okay? Limit extends to 0, tan x by x. What is tan x? Tan x is sin x by cos x. And this is tan x by x, right? So, sin x by cos x into 1 by x. Limit extends to 0. You just separate it. This is equals to limit extends to 0, sin x by x into 1 by cos x. Is there anything wrong? Nothing. Okay. So limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1. Okay. So this is 1 into, replace x with 0 in that term. So 1 by cos 0. As we know, cos 0 is also 1. So 1 into 1 is 1. So limit extends to 0, tan x by x is also 1. In the same way, there is a chance to prove that limit extends to 0, tan kx by x is equals to k. Okay, so finally, limit extends to 0, sin x by x is 1, as well limit extends to 0, tan x by x is also 1. Okay, similar to this, we have some other standard limits and I will give you those. Next one, I am erasing this. Next one is D. D. Limit extends to 0, sin inverse x by x. Okay, so again we have two options. One thing is using series expansion and the other thing is using any other standard limit. See, we need to find out this limit extends to 0, sin inverse x by x. When you replace x with 0 directly, sin inverse 0 by 0, and it is an indeterminate form. So I am not discussing, I am not mentioning that indeterminate form because it is very obvious. And to avoid that indeterminate form, what we need to do? So my idea is, you just use that sin x by x is equals to 1 again. For that, you just take sin x or otherwise x, okay, not like that. You just take x is equals to sin theta. If you take x is equals to sin theta, as x is tending to 0, theta also tends to 0, okay. As x is tending to 0, theta also tends to 0. And theta is in the neighborhood of 0. That means it lies either 0 plus something or 0 minus something. So it means that directly we have a chance to write theta is equals to sine inverse x. Okay. Take x is equals to sine theta. As x tending to 0, theta also tends to 0. And we have that theta is equals to sine inverse x. Now, completely convert the given problem in terms of theta. So this is equals to limit as x is tending to 0, theta also tends to 0. Limit theta tends to 0. This is sin inverse x. Sin inverse x is simply theta. divided by, the denominator is x. What is x? X is sin theta. So limit theta tends to 0, theta by sin theta. See, limit theta tends to 0, theta by sin theta is simply nothing but, I have a chance to rewrite it like this, 1 by limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta. By the algebra of limits, we use this type of conversion, see, different in different situations already. Okay? So 1 by limit theta tends to 0, sin theta by theta. This denominator value is 1, as we know, total value is 1. So finally, what we conclude? Limit x tends to 0, sin inverse x by x also 1. Sin x by x is 1. Tan x by x is 1. Sin inverse x by x is also 1. Okay? Similarly, we have a chance to show that limit x tends to 0, tan inverse x by x is also 1. Okay? Have a look. These are the standard limits related to inverse trigonometric functions like sin inverse and tan inverse. Next bit, E. So related to this sin and cos, trigonometric functions, inverse trigonometric functions, along with these two, we have hyperbolic functions, okay? See, actually sometimes we may face limit problems related to the hyperbolic functions. And that's why I am mentioning, hyperbolic function means they are not interpreted by sin hx or cos hx or tan hx. There is a specific definition for this sin hx, cos hx or tan hx. See, sin hx is e power x minus e power minus x by 2. Always this particular function e power x minus e power minus x by 2 is mentioned as sin hyperbolic function. And this cos hx is e power x plus e power minus x by 2. Whereas this tan hx is, just divide these two, e power x minus e power minus x by e power x plus e power minus x. Again now, if you use that, what? Yeah, limits. Limit x tends to 0 sin hx. What you say about its value? Limit x tends to 0 sin hx. Sin hx means you need to recall this particular function. Replace x with 0. When you replace x with 0, e power 0 is 1. E power 0 is 1. 1 minus 1 is 0. Directly this value is 0. But whereas, if you think about limit, yeah, x tends to 0 sin hx divided by x, then what you say about it? Already we know the expansion of e power x, as well as we know the expansion of e power x. From there we will get e power minus x, and from there we need to write expansion for sin hx. Okay, what I am saying, you need to use the expansions of e power x, e power minus x, from there sin hx, and at the end you will get that limit x tends to 0 sin hx by x value is 1. Is it clear? So in the same way, what you say about limit x tends to 0 cos hx, replace x with 0. So e power 0, e power 0, 1 plus 1 is what? 2, and 2 by 2 is 1. Okay, limit x tends to 0 cos hx value is 1. So similarly, if you say limit x tends to 0 cos hx by x, and its value is infinity. Now limit x tends to 0 tan hx is again 0, just replace x with 0 in this function, and limit x tends to 0 tan hx divided by x is again 1, just by using the series expansion of e power x. Okay, see, already I mentioned you that e power x as 1 plus x by 1 factorial plus x square by 2 factorial plus x cube by 3 factorial plus, and so on. This is e power x. Then what you say about e power minus x? Replacing x with minus x, then you will get that 1 minus x by 1 factorial plus x square by 2 factorial plus, yeah, minus x cube by 3 factorial plus, and so on. Use these two expansions in the place of e power x and e power minus x, and then try to simplify, you will get all these things. Okay, and then you just try to memorize this limit x tends to 0 sin hx by x as 1, and this limit x tends to 0 tan hx by x as 1, and all the remaining things no need to memorize. You just directly substitute x as 0, you will get the corresponding answer. That's it. Okay, have a look. So finally, at the end, as x is tending to 0, as x is tending to 0 in the sense, limit x tends to 0. So you need to place a function here. In this place, you just replace sin x by x, x by sin x, or any one of these functions. And always the value is 1. Okay? So what we conclude is, as x is tending to 0, as x is approaching to 0, all these functions, sin x by x, x by sin x, tan x by x, x by tan x, sin inverse x by x, x by sin inverse x, tan inverse x by x, x by tan inverse x, sin hx by x, and tan hx by x, all these functions are approaching to 1. Since all these functions are approaching to 1 as x is tending to 0, we will conclude that limit x tends to 0, any one of these functions in this place is always equals to 1. Okay, that's the conclusion. So to support this particular conclusion, just we mentioned you different examples and proofs in A, B, C, D of this point. Okay, and there is another way to prove all these things using geometry, and I am going to discuss that geometrical ideas in the further classes. Okay, first of all, based on series expansions of e power x, e power minus, and sin x, we have the proof for all these things. And to solve the problems, proof also not required. We need the conclusion. Okay, what is that conclusion? As x is tending to 0, all these functions are tending to 1. All these functions are approaching to 1. Okay, have a look. So, let us look at the board. See, we need to solve these problems using our standard trigonometric limits. The first one is what? Limit x tends to 0, cos ax minus cos bx by x square. What will happen if you replace x with 0? See, replace x with 0, cos 0, and this is also cos 0. Cos 0 minus cos 0 is 0, and the denominator 0 square is again 0, indeterminate form. So direct replacement, direct substituting x value is not possible here because we are getting indeterminate form. To avoid that indeterminate form, we need to use our trigonometric limits as well as trigonometric formulae. Okay? For that, for the first problem, this is equals to limit x tends to 0, cos ax minus cos bx. Use trigonometric formula. Just like cos c minus cos t. Okay? What is cos c minus cos t? Okay? Just recall that formula. Cos c minus cos d is minus 2 sin of c plus d by 2 into sin of c minus d by 2. Both are sines. So use the formula in the numerator. It will become like this. Minus 2 sin of c plus d. C plus d is simply what? Ax plus bx by 2 into sin of c minus d. That means ax minus bx by 2 divided by x square. Okay? So just cos c minus cos d formula. Use that, and then the numerator is like this. Next, what we need to do? Just have a look. It can be written as like this. This is equals to, limit x tends to 0. Send this minus inside, and this is 2 into sin of a plus b by 2 into x into sin of, since we are sending this minus inside, sin of minus theta is minus sin theta. If you send this minus inside, it will become bx minus ax. So I have a chance to write b minus a by 2x divided by x square. See, just pay attention. See, this a plus b by 2 into x is the angle here. What is the angle? You just look here. This a plus b by 2x is the angle here, and this b minus a by 2 is the angle there. So 2 sin of a plus b by 2 into x into sin of b minus a by 2x divided by x square. What we need to do? You just separate it. I am trying to convert in I am trying to convert it into the form where we can use trigonometric limits. Okay, yeah. See, this is sine of a plus b by 2 into x divided by x into sine of b minus a by 2 into x divided by x, and 2 is also there along with this. But what I need, just look there. See, sine kx by x. So we have a formula, and as a standard trigonometric limit, I am mentioning here, limit x tends to 0, sine kx by x value is directly k, as we discussed in the above point. So instead of that k, here we have this a plus b by 2. So what is this answer? A plus b by 2. And coming to here, what is this answer? B minus a by 2. At the end, this is equals to 2 into a plus b by 2 into, and that one is b minus a by 2. You just cancel 1, 2, at the end, this is b square minus a square by 2. Just have a look. Okay? Limit x tends to 0, cos ax minus cos bx divided by x square value is b square minus a square by 2. Right? Just observe it and then try to memorize. Sometimes this rule also helps us to solve different problems. Okay? This is a problem, and if you memorize it, that will help you in solving other problems also. Okay? Next one. Limit x tends to 0, 1 minus cos ax by x square. So now, 1 minus cos ax by x square. What is 1 minus cos theta? 1 minus cos theta is 2 sin square theta by 2. Okay? See, cos 2 theta. Cos 2 theta is equals to 1 minus 2 sin square theta. From there, 1 minus cos 2 theta is 2 sin square theta. So use just compare this as like that. 1 minus cos ax. So instead of 2 theta, we have ax. I will write it like this. Limit x tends to 0, 2 sin square of that angle by 2. Ax by 2 divided by x square. Okay? 2 sin square ax by 2 divided by x square. Now, if this is limit x tends to 0, this is equals to limit x tends to 0, 2 into sine of a by 2 into x divided by x, and this is completely having power 2, sine of a by 2 x divided by x. And we know this particular value is what? Sin kx by x. Limit x tends to 0, sin kx by x is k. So this is equals to 2 into a by 2 whole square. 2 into a by 2 whole square is simply nothing but a square by 2, because 4 and 2. On simplification we have a square by 2. So at the end, limit x tends to 0, 1 minus cos ax by x square is a square by 2. Okay? This formula also helps to solve this particular problem. Okay? Just add 1 and subtract 1, then utilize this formula for 2 times, again you will get same answer as you mentioned, b square minus a square by 2. Okay? So at the end, for this problem, my answer is a square by 2. Then look at this particular problem. Limit x tends to 0, 1 minus cos 3x by 1 minus cos 7x. Just divide the numerator and denominator with x square, that's enough. See, if you divide numerator and denominator with x square, so numerator is of this format, denominator is of this format, then your answer is simply t square divided by 7 square. With the help of this particular idea, divide both numerator and denominator with x square. Numerator will give you 3 square by 2 as answer. Denominator will give you by this 7 square by 2 as answer. At the end, final answer is that 3 square by 7 square. Okay? And then after that, you just think about last one, leave it. Limit x tends to 0, tan ax minus sin ax by x cube. Limit x tends to 0, this tan ax can be written as sin ax by cos x, right? So, sin ax divided by cos ax minus sin ax and whole thing is divided by x cube. From these two terms of the numerator, you just separate sign x and give one x to that. Limit expands to 0, I will write it like this. Sin ax divided by x into, took LCM in the bracket, it will become 1 minus cos ax divided by cos ax into x square. Now just observe it. This sin ax by x, its value is a sin kx by k. And this 1 minus cos ax by x square, its value is a square by 2 by this. And now meanwhile we have 1 by cos ax. In that replace x with 0, you will get that 1 by cos 0 which is 1. So finally a into 1 into a square by 2, that is equals to a cube by 2 is our answer for this problem. And then finally with this discussion of these four problems, you need to memorize this particular bit, okay? Limit extends to 0, 1 minus cos ax by x square as a square by 2. This one limit helps us in solving the other three again, okay? So memorize it as a formula, right? Have a look.